Hello, and welcome to Conquering Finale. My name is Jason Lofredo, and I will be your host for what could end up being an epically long series of tutorial videos on how to conquer Finale. So my objective with this series is not to teach you how to simply get by with Finale, but how to wrestle Finale into submission and bend it to your will and conquer it. I will attempt to do that by giving you a deep understanding of every tool and function in Finale and then show you how they all work together. So Finale is an incredibly powerful and flexible program, but what it is not is a program that will automatically fix things for you and make everything perfect. It is a trade-off. With power and flexibility comes some responsibility. Finale will happily produce anything that you ask it to, whether what you ask it to is good or not. So just remember, Finale is not a substitute copyist. The main repository for the Conquering Finale tutorials will be the website, which is at www.conqueringfinale.com. On the left, you'll see the tutorial categories. Clicking a button will send you to a new page filled with videos in that category. I'm always adding videos to the categories and whole categories themselves, so keep checking back periodically for new content. Or subscribe to my mailing list to stay updated. The videos are also categorized into playlists on my YouTube channel if you'd prefer to see them that way. And of course, subscribing to my YouTube channel will also keep you informed as new videos get added. The tutorial videos themselves will attempt to take a pretty exhaustive look at all, or hopefully all, of the functions and tools in Finale, so don't feel like you have to sit through every single minute of every video. There will be basic, intermediate, and advanced level tutorials, so feel free to skip to the level you're at or skip to a topic you feel you could use some help with. If you're an intermediate or advanced user, I do encourage you to check out some of the basic videos every once in a while. You may learn something simple that you just did not know after all those years of using Finale. So it's important to understand that Finale is a tools-based program, and the tools are generally organized by how elements function in the program, not necessarily by their musical function. For example, a slur and a hairpin, which are not musically related in any way, reside in the same tool because they're both extendable shapes that have a beginning and an ending attachment point. An accent, a fermata, and fingering numbers all reside in one tool because they attach to single notes and move up and down with those notes. Again, those items are not musically related at all. I get that this basic concept can be a little left-handed, and it can definitely be a stumbling block for people just getting started with Finale, but if you can grasp this basic idea, you'll be in a good position to start mastering the program. Since I've got the program open now, let me show you a few things that will help you get started with Finale and also with these tutorials. In the Help menu, there are some valuable resources which I encourage you to use. In particular, the Finale tutorials and Quick Start videos will indeed give you a quick primer to the program. So feel free to check these out and get a good head start. But, you know, head on back to Conquering Finale and I will definitely fill in the gaps and generally go much more in depth on pretty much all the topics. So many programs have settings or preferences. Finale is no different in this regard. In fact, Finale has two main windows for this that's worth pointing out before we get much further: the preferences and the document options. The preferences can be found in the Finale menu or by typing Command Comma. Here you will find some important preferences that will apply to the Finale application itself. These settings for things like where to save files, editing options, default view options, etc., will be specific to the Finale application on your computer. So no matter what file you have open on your computer, these preferences will be the same. However, if you open your file on someone else's computer, these settings may be different. The document options can be found in the document menu all the way at the bottom or with the keystroke combo Command Option A. These settings, as the name suggests, are options solely for the currently open document. So whether you open this file on your computer or someone else's computer, these settings will be the same for this document. I only mention this because I have witnessed Finale users that make all kinds of changes to the document options, open another file on their computer, and are disappointed that all of their musical settings didn't follow to the new file. Don't fall into that trap. Now there are ways to export and import these settings, which I'll get into at some point, or frankly, this is the main reason why professional copyists use templates. You know, set your document options once, and when you duplicate your template file, they are set for you when you start working on a new song. Anyway, more about this later, but I wanted to point out both the preferences and document options here because I will be going in and out of both of those windows a lot throughout this series. In the Finale, File, and Edit menus, you'll find a lot of options that you may be familiar with, and so I won't waste your time explaining, you know, copy and paste. I'm sure you can figure that one out, and check for updates is pretty obvious as well. But everything else that's not as obvious, I will likely cover at some point later on in this series. Now, Finale uses a system called Linked Parts, which puts your score and all of your parts in one file. Your parts will dynamically update when you edit the score and vice versa, hence the name Linked Parts. The top portion of the document menu deals specifically with linked parts. As you can see, when you select a part, it takes you to that part, and when you select score, it takes you back to the score. Command Option Period and Command Option Comma will scroll you forwards and backwards between the parts. Command Option Slash will take you back to the score no matter where you are, and if you hit it again, it will take you back to the last part you were viewing. That's Command Option Slash. We'll definitely deal a lot more with linked parts later. And also of note in the document menu is the option to display the score in concert pitch. With it checked, you're in C score. With it unchecked, you're in transposed score. The rest of the document menu I'll be getting to at some point through the course of these videos, and actually the rest of the menus at the top of the screen will become more important as we go along as well. However, it may not be a bad idea before you get much further to actually go through and read every option and sub-option in every menu, just to start to familiarize yourself with what's there. Even if you don't understand everything yet, you can start to file away in your mind what options exist and where, so that when it comes time, it won't be a surprise that a certain operation exists in a specific menu. Most tools have their own menus as well, by the way. Also note that in many places throughout these menus, you will see keystroke shortcuts next to certain functions. Those keystrokes will directly trigger those functions. Simply perusing these menus is actually a great way to learn the keystroke shortcuts or remind you of them when you forget. A big part of being efficient in Finale is knowing the important shortcuts. So do yourself a favor and start learning them as soon as you can. One more thing about these videos before we go. In the files that I'm working on, you will always see the version of Finale that I'm currently using in the bottom left corner. I will also put the version number at the end of the description for each video on the website and the YouTube page. I will always be using the most current version of Finale, so that just be aware that if you are using an older version, it's possible that some things may be slightly different or may not exist in your version. And as you can see, I will be working in a Mac OS environment, but I will do my best to provide you with Windows keystroke alternatives when I can. So, welcome to Conquering Finale. I do love feedback, so please feel free to email me at jasonconquersfinale@gmail.com. You can sign up for the mailing list, follow me on YouTube, and follow me on Twitter. There are so many ways to reach out. From time to time, I will offer one-on-one online instruction, so email me if you're interested in that, and be on the lookout for online group classes as well. And finally, you know, this project has been live for about 6 months now. It does take quite a bit of time to produce, not only shooting videos, but there's research, lesson writing, video editing, website management, all kinds of stuff that do take up a lot of my time. It is a great passion project, and, I love being able to offer these tutorials for free. But I have decided to include a donate button on the website, so, please consider making a donation. Aside from my time, there are actually a few tangible costs that I'd love to offset eventually. Like the video software and domain registration and stuff like that. So my time. Anyway, the site is always free to use, but any donation you can make would be so, so much appreciated. And I think that's it. So thanks for joining me. Let's see if we can conquer Finale together. And I'll see you on the next video.